What do we have here? Well, we've got a bonus video of some stuff I'd like to show on the show. An 18th scale die-cast model. I've never actually shown one in this scale before. We did some smaller 1/64th style scales, and those went over well. And I wanted to show you this. This is a recent reissue from the folks at Round 2 Models, the Autoworld store, 1978 Dodge Little Red Express truck. The reason I wanted to show you this one, I picked this one up myself. These are not inexpensive, but they are adult collectibles, and they are worth every penny. This was also put out before by Ertl, an excellent model, and these, the newest ones by Autoworld, like these, are gone over, and they make sure everything is perfect on them, and they're even better than they were back in the day when we first saw it. This is part of their Muscle Machines line. It's from the January 2005 issue of Muscle Machines from Hemmings, where they compared the 77 Firebird and the 78 Little Red Express. I have a huge personal connection to this model right here because I spent a large amount of my teenage years driving and riding around in a 1978 Little Red Express truck. It was a gorgeous truck. It was semi-stock. We had done some work to the motor on it, but otherwise on the outside she was all original Little Red Express truck, and it was just so much fun to ride around in, so much fun to try to curl up the pavement at every single intersection. So when I saw they were reissuing this, I had to get this and bring it in. It'll have a lot of cool things. If you never want to remove it from the box, they do a lot of cool history from the magazine about the vehicle, why Chrysler Mopar built the Little Red Express truck. It was because in the late 70s, they were starting to require emissions equipments on performance cars. That's why they killed the 426 Hemi. They didn't want to detune it and make it a wimp motor. They had already had to detune the 440s, and they really turned into dog motors after that. So in 78, though, you didn't need emissions equipment if it was a truck. So they said, all right, let's make the Warlock, let's make the Little Red Express, let's make performance trucks, because we can still have fast, fun vehicles. And in 1978, this was the fastest American production truck on the production vehicle on the road. These boxes are nice because if you don't ever want to take it out, you can also look at it from the bottom and check out all the detail with the dual exhaust, the correct Chrysler blue on the engine. But we know on the workshop, I'm not going to leave something in the box. So let me take it out, get it on the turntable, and I'll be right back. Well, it gets a lot better when it's out of the box, doesn't it? It looks a lot nicer so you can see it in person. Just so you know, if you want to unbox yours and rebox it, the clamshells that these are in come together really easy. You can see it back here. It just opens in the front and closes. So you just take the model out, and you can just set it right back in the tray like so, and then just close the ends around it and protect it, and you're all set to go. So you can see it spinning around there. It's got that gorgeous, correct Dodge Adventurer 150 nameplate, the little red nameplates. It has the little Dodge emblem on that wood. A lot of restorers forget to put that on there. With the pinstriping on the tailgate, it says Little Red Truck instead of Little Red Express Truck because I couldn't fit as much. It's got the correct wood paneling on the bed and on the sides of the bed and inside with the steel strips. The stacks are correct. The stacks were chrome. I love that they've washed inside the vents here to show us that they're actual hollow on the real thing. We'll get my pointer out so my finger doesn't keep getting in the way. But on the real thing, of course, these are shields around the exhaust pipe, and they're very heavy-duty steel. They're not real thin. They don't vibrate a lot when the truck goes down the road, and smokestacks make it even cooler. It even has a cool little metal antenna on it, just like the real thing. Gorgeous door emblems, the adventure emblems, the nice Goodyear radial GTs with the correct chrome five-slot wheels. These are the hardest things to find when guys want to restore those trucks. I know that they took them quite a while to find those wheels on the little red that I always used to hang out in. The dashboard inside is spot on. We can see that it's got the correct silver plate on it. In the very corner here coming around, you can see back there, we've got the tachometer in it. There will be still pictures at the end of this, so don't worry. But it's got the right tachometer in that dashboard instead of just a blank out. The one that I was in had the black seats, the bucket seats divided by the console. That's what this one has. And it's got that nice 360 Express engine, which was a mildly worked over police engine with the chrome valve covers and the nice work on there. It's even got the 360 Express decal inside there with the manifolds, the alternator, the overflow tank, the washer tank, a battery, a horn, and wiring are all painted up inside there. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous model. down to the silver windshield wipers. They even blackwash inside of the vents for the underneath the wipers for the vents. It's got the correct door panels in it with the hand cranks. Kids will never know what those are nowadays. It's got the nice smoker glass in it. I always love those vents that you could pop open. It's got the nice sport mirrors, chrome door handles. This thing is completely decked out. They even got the locks on there and everything. It's got the right pinstriping around the fenders, the correct 78 Dodge grill. There in 79, they changed to the square lights, so it'll look a little different. You can always tell if it's a correct 78 the first year. They made less than 8,000 of these trucks total, and most of them were built in 79 once everybody realized how cool it is. Little trivia on the little red, if you want to see one in the real world back then, the movie Urban Cowboy, in the final credits when Bud and Sissy get together and leave the rodeo at Gilly's, there is a little red truck sit right front and center in those closing credits that they show. And every time I see it, I'm like, there it is, there's the little red. So it's an excellent model, beautifully done. I'm going to take some more close-up pictures for you folks, and this will be it. So hopefully if you like this, smash that like button. Let me know in the comments. Yeah, definitely show us some more diecast because they are so cool. And I'll make sure to get more on the show for these fun little fast bonus videos. Stay tuned at the end for some more close-up pictures so you can get a better view. And we will see you at the next review.